Hi, welcome back in this new Zetamix tutorial video. Now that we saw how to print a part in the last tutorial videos, we will learn today how to debind a part. Ceramic and metal post-process are slightly different, so we will focus on ceramic post-process and debinding today. After the printing, we have a green part, which is a mix between ceramic powder and binder. The debinding process aims to remove the binder and keep only the ceramic powder without damaging the shape of the part. Debinding a part consists of two steps, the chemical debinding and the thermal debinding. The chemical debindings aim to create porosities that will enable the binder to be cleaned out without generating cracks during the thermal debinding. The chemical debinding consists of plunging a part in an acetone bath and heating it up in order to accelerate the process. To do that, we are using an ultrasound tank, but we are using only the heat option and not the ultrasound. The chemical debinding is a critical step. If it is poorly carried out, a phenomenon of delamination can appear. It can occur if you don't let the part in the acetone bath enough, and if the part is completely full and don't let the acetone to pass through. Enough theory, let's practice! The chemical debinding is properly done when the part has lost at least 5% of its mass. Therefore, the first thing to do is to weight the part before plunging it in the bath. Systematically weight the part before the chemical debinding will allow you to understand the debinding process faster. The second step is, of course, to plunge the part in the acetone bath. The thermal debinding will enable to remove the second part of the binder and only ceramic will remain. As I said earlier, if you don't let the part enough time in the tank, cracks are likely to appear when you will remove it from the acetone bath. Moreover, you cannot remove the part from the bath, check the lost mass and replunge it afterward. Crack will appear anyway. The best solution is to let the part in the bath over time if you have a doubt. Now that the part has soaked enough, we can remove it from the bath. The chemical debinding is finished. You can now weight the part to check if the mass loss is conform to the 5%. The thermal debinding will enable to remove the second part of the binder and only ceramic will remain. Then, put the thermal shields on each side of the tube. You have now to put the right program in the oven and launch the run. After the thermal debinding, the part is particularly fragile. Be careful when you handle it. It is therefore recommended to put parts from the same material on the crucible and follow the debinding and the sintering. This tutorial video is finished. You know now how to debind a part. Thank you for your attention and see you in the next video.